más allá del tiempo. Sábanas mojadas hablan las canciones.
Like a tribe does. Before this, did you really know what I was? Comprehend to the track voice. Why? Cuz getting mentions on the tip of the vibe buzz. Rock and roll to the beat of the funk fuzz. Wipe your feet really good on the rhythm rug. If you feel the urge to freak, do the jitterbug. Come and spread your arms if you really need a hug. Afrocentric living is a big shrug. My life's filled with, that's what I love. A lower plateau is what we're above. If you diss us, we won't even think of. We'll nip up a dog and give a big shove. This rhythm really hits like a stunt glove. Like a box of positives, it's a plus love.
seconds to live radio.
Very good. Top of the afternoon, sports fans, and welcome to Atrium Health Ballpark in Kannapolis, North Carolina. Johnny Wharf along for the opening game of the 2022 season of the Marietta College Pioneers. Pioneers will be in the pinstripes today under the sunshine of a North Carolina sky. Their opponent, Christopher Newport, already with seven games under their belts. And standing by is their head coach, John Harvell. We'll be back to have a word with the head coach from Christopher Newport. You're listening to the voice of the Etta Express. Short break it. Hey Ben, they got me going over speaker here, so I'll play these interviews back here too.
I'm sorry, what's that?
Rule B for Division III baseball is when NCAA selects the tournament teams, Pool B, there are all those teams in the country that don't have an automatic bid. And with us losing teams from our conference last year, it knocked us under the number that required to get the automatic bid. So now we're looking at a very few amount of bids that are available in Pool B. So, you know, we're really going to rely on the strength of our schedule, and that's why we scheduled the way we did this year.
John Harvell, head coach of Christopher Newport, a trip to Demarest. I always love that trip, so how's that looking? It's pretty good.
Yeah, it was great. You know, we played Birmingham Southern down there, who traditionally is NCAA, and then Cal Lutheran, who won the national championship a couple of years ago, and of course, Piedmont always plays well down there. So it was a good start for our guys, and again, those guys down there, I actually coached against when they played in college, so I've known them for years, so I always enjoy going down there and playing them, and they always bring good competition in, and it lets our guys know right away what we need to do to get better.
22nd year coach with the Captains. How do you scout a team that hasn't hit the field yet?
Well, it doesn't matter with them because me and Brian and Marietta go way back 2002 and 3 in the World Series. So it doesn't matter whether or not they've been inside, outside. I know they're going to be well prepared. Brian has always done a great job with them, and that's definitely a team that I'm not worried about where they've been in the last couple of weeks, because I know once they step foot on that field, they're going to be ready to play.
If we were home, that would have been Brian that went by on the tractor, by the way. But tell me one or two names that you hope step up for you today if you're going to win this game.
Well, the guy we're throwing today, Jay Cassidy, we think he's going to be really special. He's off to a great start for us. He actually hits and pitches for us. So if he can continue to fill up the zone like he did, I think he's going to give us a chance today. Right now, offensively, we're still trying to find ourselves. We've had some guys really step up. A freshman, Kevin Magman, has played well his few starts that he's gotten this year. And, you know, we've got some other guys, Justin Bauer, who's a transfer, who's played well the last couple of games. So if we can get a complete offensive game, I think, you know, this could be a real competitive game today.
All right, Coach, good to see you again.
Thank you.
Get better every game, all right?
Yep, thank you. I appreciate it. Good talking to you.
All right, John Harbell, head coach of Christopher Newport, back with more from Atrium Health Ballpark, Annapolis, North Carolina, right after this.
Yeah.
Pre-game along with Coach Brian Brewer, game on the 2022 NA Express schedule. Christopher Newport on tap and a road trip and a facility and, you know, all that comes with getting a season started, Coach.
Yeah, there's a lot to it, obviously, but, you know, it'll all be worthwhile here in about an hour or so or whatever it is. We're getting kicked off, but super excited, man. Everything's been great. The road trip was easy, right down 77. Had a little bit of fog, but nothing bad. Got in here and got some swings in the cage last night, some fly balls in the outfield. The people here at the stadium have been terrific, incredibly hospitable, as well
about the close? What about the?
And then, you know, I would say, you know,
you're way behind because you're listening to the screen. 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back to Kannapolis, North Carolina. Johnny Wharf on a little solo flight. We'll have some guests in over the course of the day, but a beautiful day. Really rain all the way here when you think about the trip from Marietta Inn, which I did this morning with Wendy Brewer, the coach's wife, and my lovely sister. But baseball just around the corner. Coach Brian Brewer and the head coach of Christopher Newport, Coach John Harvell, at home plate, 3 umpires. That's always a good sign that things are not too far from getting underway. The home opener, always exciting, and this is a team that comes in, Christopher Newport, that Marietta is well familiar with as they exchange lineups. We'll roll down through your lineups as well. Game day lineups brought to you on the radio by Honest Fred's Flooring. Take the short drive to make savings at honestfreds.com and put your money where your feet are. Honest Fred's Flooring with stores in Parkersburg, Spencer, and Marietta. And right around the corner from the ballpark on Pike Street, Honest Fred says, play ball. Christopher Newport under Coach John Harvell already 3-4 on the season. Took that trip into Demarest and picked up a couple other games. We'll touch on those as we roll. But they'll start their center fielder leading things off, Connor Clark, followed by Scott Crossen, the right fielder, and Jay Cassidy, who you heard about as the pitcher and the DH. So the guy on the bump will bat in the 3 spot. Kyle Schofield batting in the 4 spot. He's their first baseman. Justin Bauer is a left fielder batting number 5. Batting number 6 playing second base is Daniel Elliott. Kevin Mackman is the third baseman in the 7th spot. Kind of a short game guy. I think he's played about half of them, but he's got good numbers. Drew Caroline is the catcher batting 8th, and Jonathan Fisher, the shortstop, batting in the 9th spot. We take a look at the Pioneers in the pinstripes. You know what I say, having done this for 25 years, I don't feel like the season is underway until I see the pinstripes at Sue and Don Shally Field at Pioneer Park. And so we're not quite there yet. Soon enough, though, right? But I do see the pinstripes under a North Carolina blue sky today. Beautiful clouds up above, sunshine all about, and what feels like a really good baseball day. Should top into the mid-70s today here in Kannapolis, North Carolina. And we'll give you a little backstory on Kannapolis as well. But as we pulled in here a little while ago, they talked, ran into a guy that asked who was playing, and we gave him the down low on the teams that were in for this weekend. And he says it wasn't too long ago when there was nothing across the street. They put $5 million into the field. This area boomed up, and it is really happening. There's a brewery across the street. There's restaurants. There's all kinds of great concessions here in a minor league ballpark of the Chicago White Sox. So that is the setting, and we'll kind of lay it out for you as well. But defensively for the Pioneers, these are names that you'll be familiar with, other than maybe a couple of youngsters out there. But you're going to find Zach Boyd in left field. Brett Carson, there's a new name for you, in center field. Then Turner Hill, first-team All-American preseason, will be in right field. Damian Yenzi is at third base. Matthew Busby at shortstop. A.J. Lovin is at second base. Drew Holderback at first. Logan Wittmeyer is behind the dish. And we will see Gino Sabatino on the hill to start the season for the Pinstripes this year. We'll also honor America here in a matter of moments, but at this time, we'll take a moment to take a look at the field, brought to you by Apex True Value at the corner of 7th and Green Streets, home of the Saturday Morning Apex Feed, Seed, Fertilizer, Nuts, and Bolts Show. You heard me do that this morning. Apex has what it takes to make your yard look like a field of dreams, and that is exactly what we have here in Kannapolis, home of the KC Ballers. That is the minor league team of the White Sox, but we'll see 315 down the lines. We will see 388. There's a backstory on that down in center field. And then a little bit of a jagged where the field comes in. You might, I would liken it to Peden Stadium, where you can sit in the end zone on the grass. So there's a little bit of that in left field. But that's a look at the field. It's a grass infield and dirt pass, so natural grass infield. Both teams lining up. Pioneers in the pinstripes will set the stage as they come out of the first base dugout. They are in the pinstripes, and Christopher Newport in royal blue trimmed in gray, and we will take this time to honor America for the playing of the national anthem, brought to you on the radio by Marietta's American Legion, Post 64. Days and Forever, one of my favorite songs. And as well, on a baseball field, none better than to look down and see our Marietta College Pioneers as they step onto the field or get ready to take the field. We're pretty excited to get things started. And a fan from the stands, right? Steve Hill rolls in here. How's it going, man? How was your trip down here?
It was great. We hit a little bit of rain, but nothing too bad. Had some fog in the mountains, but again, nothing too bad. It was a nice little drive down here. Some beautiful sunshine, beautiful stadium, and good to see Ed Express back on the diamond.
Hey, Steve, I rolled in, and I went right to getting interviews, getting lineups, getting book filled out, and so I haven't made the rounds. Tell me, have you been into, you know, some of these different areas? Tell me a little bit about this.
Yeah, I got in town and walked around the town here. It's a beautiful little town. Kind of reminds you a little bit of Marietta, that little feel of, hey, come in my shop here. Everybody seems to be pretty friendly so far. Beautiful little sidewalks to walk on, and yes, yeah, a nice little town here.
Did you think it was going to be this nice for first pitch? Think about what it was like this morning.
You're right. We left home, had a little bit of frost in the windshield to get down here, like, all right, this is baseball weather here. Let's play.
Yeah, so Steve Hill joining me, and it seems like a lot of folks in. I saw some names and some folks that might roll in here, former Pioneers and John Snyder, Hendricks, Scholl, Sherman, Fatsinger. I'm assuming guys that are from the area, right, rolling in?
Absolutely, and I even seen some former family members. I saw the Wiggins are here.
Oh, really?
I saw Brady Cottom's parents are here. So, and I know they're from this area. They're actually from the Charlotte area, so they're not too far from here, the Cottoms. So, yeah, great season of Pioneer fans here.
Nobody knows better than you. It's just hard to shake out of the system once you get a taste of it, right? You want a little bit more.
Man, I mean, you know, of course, you know, this is such a long history of just of winning. What a great tradition how they do things here. But, you know, once you come watch these guys play, you want to come to every doggone game you can.
Well, we heard from Coach John Harvell pregame, and a lot of respect. This is a team that we know well enough, and they're – basketball team is in there. Remember, we saw at the beginning of the year, like, oh boy, here we go again, right? And their basketball team's in the postseason rolling as well. So good to have this collision of sports and a couple of teams that are well familiar with each other. And we are ready for the first pitch of today's game, brought to you by our friends at Pioneer Family Auto Group, where you can stroll 7 lots in the Mid-Ohio Valley or surf the inventory at pioneerfamilyauto.com. Chevrolet, Ford, Buick, GMC, Honda, Volkswagen, Mazda, what else do you need for the most reliable transportation, the best local car buying experience? It's got to be Pioneer Family Auto Group, proud to sponsor the first pitch of today's game. Sabatine on the bump. He is a righty, and out of the gate, he's going to face a lefty by the name of Connor Clark. Clark already with the dinger on the young season, so he's got some power from the left-hand side. Signed from Bittmeyer. Pitch underway, and we are underway as well. It is a ball to the plate to Connor Clark. Gino kicks and deals, and this pitch is on the money, and some pretty good heat coming off the right hand of Gino Sabatine. A little flat bill, you know, Gino kind of cocked off to the side a little bit. That's what we're used to seeing from Gino. And there's a ball hit left side, up with it, shortstop Busby. He's gonna have to one hop it over, but just back in the hole a little too far. And my first instinct, correct me if I'm wrong, Steve, but that looked like a little slow infield.
A little slow infield, looked like the water had played us in there. Looked like the dirt a little wet. And the kid got out of the left-hander batter's box pretty fast. Looks like the leadoff hitter's got some speed there.
Infield single. And just back on the grass, Busby gathered that up, but we're going to go back-to-back lefties, and Scott Crossan will step in. This is the team leader per batting average, again, on a very young season, 7 games in, 385 is number, and he's going to drop a bunt out in front of the plate, picked up bare hand by Gino, and the throw is going to be in and around the chin of the base runner, which will allow the lead runner to move to third, and all hands are safe. E1. Runners on the corners. And the big stick of Jay Cassidy. When you're a pitcher and a hitter, you probably know how to swing it. And it's going to be the third in a row into the left-hand batter's box with runners on the corners. Runner moving on the bunt over to third when the ball got away. The throw was just up head high toward the bag. And again, you know, holder back in there would want that ball toward the second base side with the runner coming down.
you know, back-to-back speed right there. Gino, again, had to hurry on that. I mean, so far the first two hitters look like they got some wheels on them. So,
pitch down low, ball one. Third batter to the plate, Jay Cassidy, pitcher, DH. Number 17 on the Royal Blue jersey. And the count 1-0. From the stretch for the first time for Sabatine. Pitch delivered, misses a little bit low. You heard it smack the mitt of Logan Wittmeyer. Pioneers in the first base dugout. And Brew pacing the cage. Already over for a drink. Next pitch, swing and a miss. Little piece of it, did get a little piece of it, but that's the first strike at the plate. Fastball at the knees, two balls and a strike. Good cut from Cassidy, though, batting in the three spot.
Looks like Gino's hitting a spot, so we just got to get a nice little ground ball here, get a double play of this.
Check a runner behind him and a runner in front of him and a throw over to first. And back head first in there is number 8, Connor Clark. Cleanup hitter on deck. Love to get one here, though. Again, to the stretch for Sabatine. And a pitch delivered. Ball rip shot. Boyd. Middle. Relay. Did they get it? Yeah. How about the first double play of the year? We'll see the first run given up as well. But a nice little 6-4-3. Busby, A.J. Lovin in the middle. And Drew Holder back on the back end. Gets a couple of outs, but scoring on the play is Crossan. And it's 1-0 Christopher Newport with Kyle Schofield coming to the plate in what would be four in a row lefties. Here's a ball hit. Lovin back on the grass at second. We'll throw over to Holder back, and that'll do it in this first half inning of baseball. One run, one hit, one error, and nobody left the board. We played a half inning of baseball in Kannapolis, North Carolina. It is Christopher Newport 1, Marietta College coming to bat. You're listening to the voice of the Atta Express. In this ball game, and now we've got a lefty on the bump as well. This is Jay Cassidy. You heard Coach Brian Brewer in the pregame say this is their guy. They held him out of the last game so they could have him for this one. And you also heard their head coach, John Harvell, saying we are playing the toughest competition we can, trying to get a good spot since their league doesn't have an automatic bid into the postseason. First pitch is a strike. Second one misses away, and that'll even the count to Turner Hill. Number 17 on the back of Cassidy. And a long look in this time before he delivers the next one, which is up and in to Turner Hill. So Hill back kind of up into the count, if you will. Two balls and a strike. Catcher behind the dish is Drew Caroline. Sights the sign, and this one is fouled back. And what would have been right in the breadbasket had there not been a net there, because that was mine, and I was ready. I think I was ready to get it, and we'll never know. But I feel like I'm kind of in preseason form. I don't know for sure. Would like to find out, but maybe not. Two balls, two strikes. And the 2-2 to Hill. Ball swung on. This is hit and hit hard out to left field. Left fielder with the sun banging off his mirrored blue sunglasses will make the catch, and there's one down. Bat on ball. It's always good right out of the gate. That'll bring Damian Yenzi to the plate. Christopher Newport, a two-year branch of the College of William and Mary. There's a pitch home called strike, first one to Jens. Yenzi, the first right-handed batter that we've seen to the plate. And there were four captains of Newport and of course Turner. So through six batters, and Jens is the first righty, and there's one that's called strike. Back-to-back strikes delivered from the left-handed pitcher to the right-handed batter, Yenzi. In a one-out, bottom of the first, scheduled for nine, Pioneers the home team. Holder back on deck. 0-2 to Yenzi. Swing and a miss on a high fastball. Ruby Red comes up short on three pitches. And the two-out batter is Drew Holderback. And Coach Brian Brewer talked about the gun on this guy on the hill and that he is their man. Win with him, lose with him, but he's their guy as of right now. We know it's the long season ahead, and we'll see Holderback step in. A first pitch look on a changeup, and it's called strike on the inside corner. So he pumps the heat in to get Jens, and then he throws a changeup right out of the gate to Holderback. And the next one on the way, fastball swung on. This one is lifted out to left center field. Center fielder drifting back. Left fielder is there as well. Had to reach up, but did pull it down. And pretty good wheels for Connor Clark. And what ends up being a three up, three down, bottom of the first for the Marietta College Pioneers. One full inning in the book. Christopher Newport 1, Marietta nothing. You're listening to the voice of the FRS.
I'm on in, I might come.
The pitcher, first pitch strike delivered as we start the second inning. Second one's going to get the batter. And if it wasn't baseball, you'd probably not want to do that to Justin Bowers. He is a big cat, and he's got a free pass. If you call that free, and I'm going to guess he would, just caught him on the bicep. And he is safely on at first base. That'll bring Daniel Elliott to the plate. And as Bowers gets a lead out of Yorktown, Virginia. George Washington had a good battle there. He's a junior. I've got him at 6'5", 220. That's the base runner. First pitch home is a strike to yet another lefty, Daniel Elliott. Holder back holding the runner. Pitch delivered. Looked good. Is good. And it's 0-2.
Be a great time for those Geno ground balls right about now.
Yeah, already the Pioneers turning the first 6-4-3 of the year. Again, pitching from the stretch. Sabatine, and this is a throw over. And the big 6'5" guy just really falls back in. Sunshine all about. Maybe a little bit of shade down by the first base area from the big Atrium Health Ballpark sign. There's one down in the dirt. I don't know that it was so much a waste. Usually when you see what we refer to as the waste pitch, and it's going to be away, this one was down in the dirt, and a little bit of work for Wittmeyer, but the runner stays put. Good stop by Logan. Throw over. And the runner back in there safely. One ball, two strikes. Daniel Elliott, the batter. Justin Bowers, the base runner. Sabatine, Wittmeyer, the battery. Stretch. And the 1-2. Ball hit left side and fouled off. And the netting goes all the way down to what would be the bullpen area at, if you want to think about Pioneer Park. So the netting goes all the way down and around the dugouts. Here's a ball hit left side. Busby up, falling back over to get the lead runner and does so. Good play by Matthew as it was kind of going away, if you will. Scored 6-4. Fielder's choice allows
another left-handed hitter. My goodness.
His name's Kevin Mackman. He has the top batting average on this team, yet they don't put him up top because he's only played half of the games. But in those games, leads the team and runs batted in 5. Now you know why he's in the starting lineup, swing and a miss, and a couple of doubles. So in 4 games, he's produced. His name's Kevin Mackman, number 34. And number 32 in the pinstripes on the bump. Geno working him. Next pitch. Looked good. Is good.
Great looking changeup right there by Geno.
0-2. It's a little hospitality room here. Tara Meagle stopped by a little while ago. Josh Jacobs with development. There's a pitch that misses a little high. Could have been strike 3, by the way, but
very close.
Little generous, if you will. Early on. It's early on in the game, but hospitality room for some of the Marietta College alums and folks that have come down here with the development department. So hopefully an opportunity will. There's a ball swung on, and this is just reaching out and serving an outside pitch into left field. And I'm not so sure that Mackman wouldn't shake his hands after that one as well. But he is on safely. He'll push that runner, Elliott, over to second. And what would represent the second base hit of the ball game for Christopher Newport. They do have a run across. Now a couple of runners on and one out. Inner number 11 to the plate. This is the catcher, Drew Caroline. He's the eighth batter in the lineup and the fourth batter in this inning. Runners lead first and second. Pitch delivered, a little swing bunt. If it stays fair, it's trouble. It stays fair and it's trouble. That's a bunt single, a little swinging bunt single off the bat of the catcher that allows Caroline on safely and advances all runners. Pioneers back at double play depth. A good play call.
That was a nice bunt. He waited the last second to show it, threw it down there, and it just stayed right down on the grass, right down the line.
Inner Jonathan Fisher, he represents the order in total for the captains as he steps in to the right-hand batter's box. Nowhere to put him. Pitch delivered. Misses low, ball one. Vitt says, okay, Gino, that's where I ask you to put it. And I'm good with that. Second inning baseball, top half thereof. 1-0 Christopher Newport, and they threaten with the bases jammed. Pitch swung on, fouled off. That will even the count. And we'll draw our line of sight down that first baseline where Pioneer fans are sitting in the sunshine of this beautiful day and in North Carolina. Carolina blue sky. Here's the 1-1. Fastball strike, 1-2. Vittmeyer is up and had the gun cocked to fire down to first, only to see that runner chase back that way. I don't really think he was going to throw. 1-2. Give me a big out, Gino. Here's the 1-2. Little changeup. Ball hit out into right field. Charging hard. Turner. And reaching down, a little basket catch, Say Hey style. And the run will tag and score. The second out is recorded in right field by Hill. So that takes Fisher out of the picture.
Yeah, that's one of those plays there. Turner's wanting to come up, fire to the plate, had a layout for it, went to the ground, time to get to his feet. Again, Christopher Newport, the speed. They're showing some Brewer-like type baseball. It's a couple bunts so far today, moving runners, running fast.
Ends up going in the book as a sack fly for Fisher. And brings the top of the order to the plate with runners at first and second. And gets the PA fired up a little bit with the music. Sabatine will sight the sign. Check a runner at second. Pitch delivered, big swing and a miss. Strike one. So Gino in the second inning, as he gets and finds his groove, is getting ahead of the batters. No balls and a strike, two out and two on.
Yeah, Gino's hitting the spots. They haven't really hit him hard. They just play some small ball baseball. Get him on, get him over, move him in.
There's a ball swung on and by a diving second baseman out to Turner Hill, who comes up throwing. And they got the number on him. They will hold tight at second base. And that'll load him up again for the captains. A well-hit ball, screaming by A.J. Lovin at second as he stretched over toward it. Will go as a single in the book and load him up with Scott Crossan coming to the plate. And back to the left-hand side of the plate. Back-to-back singles for that leadoff guy, Clark. Crossan had reached on an error. And with that pitch, first pitch coming in is ball one, away. Again, nowhere to put this guy, and a ball swung on. This one is lifted out to left, heading into the corner, and
it
is going to sneak into the corner. One run, two runs coming around. They'll get a throw to the plate, but not be able to get a tag on. And you can hear the captains and Christopher Newport brought a little fan base with them as well. Scoring from second, Kevin Mackman, and then Drew Caroline in front of him coming across to score. Connor Clark moved over to we're going to see Coach Mike Mulvey for the first time.
You know, you wonder, Johnny, how much plays into this? These guys, you know, coming down a little farther south, start their season out on the diamond a little quicker than the guys in the north. How much does that play into this, these guys early in the season like this?
Oh, and you have to think so. You can bet Coach Harvell got them jacked up for this game. They got their ace on the bump. They're in a different spot. They spent a little time in Demarest, Georgia. And, they're starting to feel it.
Yeah, absolutely. This is a good program right here.
So, Coach Mike Mulvey played his ball here at Marietta College, went on to coach as an assistant at Muskingum, came into the fold here a couple years ago, and has really done a nice job. He's going to try to settle Gino down a little bit with still the duck on the pond. And a 4-0 score with the runs coming across in the inning. Big double into the corner for the guy who stands out there, Scott Crossan. And a new batter at the plate in the form of Jay Cassidy, who is the pitcher and looks at a first pitch strike. And then a swinging strike that gets through the wickets and the runner will move down.
Great pitch by Gino, keeping that ball down, mixing up speeds right there. Had number 17 out in front. Cassidy just swung right through that pitch.
Passed ball is the charge on that one to allow Crossan to move down. Sorry, Yaz, it's the official score, man. I'm just giving you the official scoring. No balls and two strikes. Pitch up high, and that'll be the first ball to Cassidy. Cassidy represents the eighth player to the plate in the second inning. So on deck, the batting order in total. We'd like to just save that. There are two outs. Next pitch delivered, misses a little bit low. And the right-hander deals, and a ball swung on, ripped right up the middle, over the second base bag, another single, and another run scored. As Christopher Newport will have a bat around second inning. And coming in to score, Crossan. Cassidy safely on with the single, and Kyle Schofield comes to the plate. Fifth run of the inning for Christopher Newport. They lead 6-0. First pitch delivered is a ball. Cassidy gets a lead, and the next pitch misses away. Schofield, the batter. Boys are rocking their numbers now in terms of the RBI count on this captain team. Next pitch misses. Two balls and a strike. Lefty at the plate is Kyle Schofield. Grounded out to end the first inning. And a throw over. And the runner's back safely at first. Vit Meyer will hang the sign. And the 2-1 on the way hit right up in about the same spot. Over second base, into the glove, or before it hits the ground, or after it hits the ground, Brett Carson out there brings it in. So another base hit. And it is a bat around and then some inning. Five runs in the inning. Now 10 batters as the righty comes to the plate. And this is Bowers. He's the guy that got it all started. You might remember, which certainly seems like some time ago He got hit by the second pitch of this inning. And there's a ball swung on. It is a line drive, but thankfully into the mitt of an at-the-ready A.J. Lovin, Pioneer second baseman, and that'll do it in the inning. So 10 batters come to the plate, 5 runs cross on 7 base hits, no Pioneer errors, 1 runner left on board. We are headed mercifully to the bottom of the second inning with a little bit of work to do. It is Christopher Newport 6, Marietta nothing. You're listening to the voice of the Atta Express. Thank you. Well, we will see 4-5-6 for the first time today for the Atta Express in the pinstripes today on a beautiful day. Kannapolis, North Carolina, named after a textile mill and or the guy that started that, James William Cannon. Cannon with the C, although the city is with a K, but the Cannon Mills Corporation back in the day is what built this city. Not rock and roll, but...
Pitch down to Logan, taking ball one.
Vittmeyer, Boyd, Page due up for Marietta. And Jay Cassidy on the hill with little Cush behind him, man. How about 7 runs?
Oh, boy.
There's a ball swung on by Vittmeyer. Hit out to center field, shading the sun, making the catch is Connor Clark. But a good bat on ball there for Vitt. But will just be a long, loud out number one.
Logan's got some crazy power.
So we are northeast of Charlotte. Population of about 46,000. And specifically this field, Atrium Health Ballpark, there's a first pitch ball away to Zach Boyd. It was a low-A baseball affiliate of the Phillies, and now it is of the White Sox, the Cannonballers.
So right in the middle of NASCAR country, right, Johnny? So did I hear right this at one time was owned by Dale Earnhardt?
Yeah.
Is correct?
Yeah, the team was the Intimidators, if you follow racing. And you also notice the 388 center field.
Absolutely.
And the 3 in the 388 feet. Is in the NASCAR style 3 of Dale Earnhardt, and the 88 is of Dale Earnhardt Jr. So that's a different font than the rest of it. Evan Brockmeyer filled me in on this, by the way.
Okay.
So, you know, he's not going to.
Yeah.
He's going to tell it like it is, right?
Okay.
There's one fouled off.
Now, is this that here, right? Is this the hometown of Dale Earnhardt or no?
Yeah. That's what I gathered the Earnhardt family from here.
Okay.
I think, yep, that is the case. 2 balls, 2 strikes, and a called strike 3, and a little heater home from Jay Cassidy. We'll take him right off the front of the mound, and the boys will whip it around the horn. Getting a feel
for a little bit of Friday daytime baseball. Two outs. Pioneers have gone quietly through five batters, and AP is going to try to make a little noise. Number seven steps in to the right-hand side of the plate, Alex Page. And a ball swung on, and that's a little bit of noise. That's
there we go.
Base hit to left field as he gets the Atta Express off the snide. And the first base hit of the season for the Marietta College Pioneers. If you have that trivia question later on in the year, you'll have to remember Alex Page.
I think Alex was up there looking for a first pitch strike, and he put a good barrel on it. A nice line drive to left field right there.
Enter Brett Carson into the left-hand side of the plate. Carson is out of Taes Valley.
Yeah, he transferred here from Muskingum University. Last year's actually Muskingum's top hitter.
Yeah, for the Muskies.
Yeah. Brett also throws, he's a lefty off the bump. He also throws off the bump for the Ed Express this year. I think Coach Brewer is planning on using him this year.
Might have brought that Muskie bat with him.
Hey.
Ruby red it is.
Yeah.
Whatever works.
Absolutely. If he can get us a nice little base knock here and keep the hit rolling, we'll be all right.
That axe handle bat and into the left-hand side of the plate. We've yet to see the pitch home to Carson, but a base runner in Alex Page. Lefty pitcher facing the runner, and a ball swung on, and this one is popped up. Foul territory, third baseman giving chase. Realized maybe at the last minute he had a little extra room, and then a little extra room. That's how high that was up in the air, and then it just gets out over the net. But Kevin Mackman trying to get a feel for how much space he has over there, and probably more than he has on his home field, because he had a good ways to go and he used it all.
Yeah, the bullpens are actually on the field here, so that gives you a little extra room for you in foul territory running those down.
Johnny Wharf, Steve Hill jumping into the booth here as well for a bit. There's a strike called, so quickly 0-2 on the batter, Brett Carson. Number eight in the pinstripes. He's the center fielder. Again, as Steve mentioned, a transfer from Muskingum and a senior. And the 0-2 ball hit right side. Slow roller, second base up. Backhand flip to middle. And they will get the lead runner and get out of the inning. 4-6 is the putout. No runs, one hit, no errors. And one runner left to board with play two complete, scheduled for 9. It is Christopher Newport, 6, Marietta nothing. You're listening to the voice of the Atta Express. Thank you. Three. The captains will be at Daniel Elliott. So 6-7-8 due up for the captains of Christopher Newport.
Elliott grounded to a 6-4 fielder's choice as first AB.
First pitch is a strike delivered to start this third inning of baseball. It was a 10 bat around inning for Christopher Newport in the last inning. Here's one that gets around and will draw our line of sight down into the bullpen, where we will see number 23, a freshman by the name of Zach Marzette. That's Marietta College Pioneer. Zach Marzette, 6'2", 188. He's out of Blacklick, Ohio, so Gahanna Lincoln, his high school, and he is warming up in the Marietta College bullpen, the right-hander. Sabatine will sight the sign of Wittmeyer. 6-0, Christopher Newport on top. And so here's a batter that looks at a first pitch called strike. He gets way around on the next pitch and fouls it down the line first base. He's late swinging on the third pitch, thinking, uh-oh, this could be strike three. So he fouls it off the other way. And here's the 0-2. And it's a rip right up the middle. And he was ready for that one. And that is a four-pitch base hit to get things started for Christopher Newport here in the third. That's Daniel Elliott. And that'll bring Kevin Mackman to the plate, number 34 for Christopher Newport.
Yeah, Mackman singled the left in his first at AB. It's a little looping liner over the shortstop's head.
Check the runner and back to the stretch, where Sabatine has spent most of his time on the bump, and a first pitch strike is delivered. So Dale Earnhardt buys the team here and then tragically dies, as most people are familiar, the following year. So that was 2000. And here's a ball swung on. It's a hot shot. Holder back on one bounce up over
there, you
cover.
Go. There you go.
And that's the one you practice in the gym, guys. That's Gino coming off the bump to cover the double play. Charging Holder back, gets it, fires over to Busby, who then returns over to Sabatine at first, and it becomes the rare 3-6-1 twin killing.
Gina did a great job getting over and covering his position, but how nice is it to have Drew Holder back at first base?
Yes.
I mean, that guy is just Mr. Automatic.
Drew Caroline, two-out batter, first pitch swinging, third base, Yenzi up, over. And that'll do it. So a roundabout way, three up, three down. For the first time, go the captains of Christopher Newport in the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, nobody left the board. We head to the home half of the third inning. The captain 6, the Pioneers nothing. You're listening to the voice of the Atta Express. Thank you. Little retail area with food establishments and a brewery and some shops across the way, and that is a bunt out in front. Got a little English on it, and falling to the ground is Cassidy. Really good backup by the second baseman. A.J. Lovin is going to be safely on, and a bunt base hit for Lovin. And the second base hit in three batters for the Pioneers, so maybe they're get things cooking here a little bit. But Lovin down the line. The bunt wasn't great by Steen. A.J. Lovett would say that wasn't a great bunt. Coach will tell him that as well. It got popped up, but it comes down with a little bit of English. And I think you've got a pitcher who's bare, getting ready to barehand it and sees it spin off. And then he falls to the ground as he is throwing. You can actually see the skid mark in the grass out in front of the plate where his heel skidded. And then a first pitch strike to Busby. Busby showed bunt there as well and then moved way up in the plate and actually looked at a strike on a pitch that almost hit him, but it's because he moved up toward the plate. Check of the runner, Lovin. And the 0-1. Ball swung on, popped up sky high infield. Not quite a silo shot, but pretty close. First baseman will come in and make the play, which will give us an opportunity as well to give a little love to Daniel Elliott out there. He's the second baseman. And when that throw from the pitcher Cassidy went down to get Lovin, he was there to back up in a really good spot. When that ball got away, he was right there because Lovin's first instinct when he saw the ball skip away was to move over to second base, but a really good backup by Daniel Elliott. And that happens for a couple. Sometimes it doesn't happen as well this early in the season. You know, these guys are just getting used to things, but that also comes when you're on a really good team and you're trying to keep your spot. You got to do all the things right. A throw over to first runner back safely.
Yeah, and on that play, Coach Brockmeyer in perfect position to make sure Lovins doesn't take off. He put himself in position so he could see the play and also have a voice with Lovins on that.
One ball, no strikes. Top of the order, Turner Hill to the plate for the second time. Fly out to left field, his lone at bat in this ball game and on this season. Runner at first, has him leaning back a little bit. Hill shows bunt and then pulls the bat back for ball two. Two balls and a strike. Six to nothing is the score. Christopher Newport's last inning, the only inning they didn't score in. Put one up in the first and five up in the second. They lead 6-0. Pitch home, called strike. And that is the first strike to number 38, Turner Hill. Two balls in and a strike to Turner. Again, preseason first team All-American from the stretch. And a pitch is going to be ball three. Runner on at first base. One out. That was the pop-up in the infield. Turner, your reigning OAC Player of the Year. There's ball four. That'll put him on first base. And so Pioneers with runners at first and second. And, you know, based on what we saw through the first couple of innings, it's something to get excited about right now.
Absolutely. You know, but at the same time, it's game number one, and Coach Brewer talked about, I mean, he's excited about the offense of this team. Right now would be a good time to get something going here.
And Turner to get on base. That's hard to take some of those pitches. A guy coming off a season that batted 449 with 18 doubles and 32 runs batted in. Good eye up there for him. And now to the plate, we'll see Damian Yenzi. Runners at first and second. One out. Pitch home. Swung on. There's a ball hit into left field. And that is going to send a runner around third. Throw coming in. Not going to be in time. And you get a good feel maybe for the number of Pioneer fans that made the trip into here when you hear that ovation in the background.
That's something we've seen Yenz do time and time again. He's one of those players, like, when you need him the most, he seems to come through.
RBI single, Damian Yenzi. And scoring on the play is A.J. Lovin. Turner Hill moves into second base. And runners at first and second. One out batter is Drew Holder back. Lefty on the hill. Checks the runners, delivers inside a ball.
Coach Brewer yelling out the signs down there. Kind of went away from the old school hand signals. Went to the number system. What was it, last year, first year
of
that?
Yeah. third team preseason All-American, number one for the Pioneers. First baseman Drew Holderback will look at a strike. So one ball, one strike, one out, two runners on base, and sunshine all about on a Friday in Kannapolis, North Carolina.
Drew's one of those guys that, I mean, he can open this thing up right now and start getting some things rolling.
Pitch on the way.
Ooh, nice cut.
Swing and a miss. And that'll bring the count to a ball and a couple of strikes. Runners at first and second. And again, they check the belt buckles. They have that scorecard on the front of their belts. They check the numbers that come in. Runners with good leads, none being held. Ball swung on this one, hit to the right side and out into front of the right fielder. So that'll load him up. Good job and quickly to get the ball as Scott Crossan. And that'll be back-to-back base hits.
That's a great piece of hitting by Drew. Two-strike approach, just stayed down on it. Took the pitch to right field and just put it out there where they ain't.
Coach Turner Hill into third base. Damian Yenzi at second base. Drew Holderback at first. Logan Wittmeyer, the batter, with still but one out. And the Pioneers looking to make the most of an opportunity here in what is the bottom of the third, scheduled for nine. Number 29, Logan Wittmeyer into the right-hand batter's box and on the hill with the ball behind his back, and now gloving it is Cassidy. He'll sight the sign and deliver. And a first pitch changeup strike delivered to the plate. A little off-speed pitch, started away and zipped into the strike zone.
Logan is a crazy strong kid. It's nice to see him climb into something here, find a gap somewhere.
The ball's in a strike. Check swing, and it gets down into the dirt. Good job to keep it in front of him by the catcher. But it becomes a ball at the plate, one ball, one strike. So this area also surrounded by a lot of, I think I saw North Carolina Institute, biomedical research, just a bunch of smart people everywhere we look around here.
Makes me feel out of place, Johnny.
One ball, one strike, one out, bases loaded. And a pitch on the way. And that one is going to miss a little bit high. And so that'll bring us to two balls and a strike. It was a good pitch. And see the catcher try to frame it. And now Wittmeyer, just a bump ahead on the count. Two balls and a strike. And to the stretch again, Cassidy will check the runner at second. Pitch swung on, hit right to the third baseman who hesitates a little bit. They do get the force out at home, and I'm not sure exactly what the hesitation was for Kevin Mackman in terms of trying to do a little 5-2-3 is what I thought they'd try to do. They'll get the lead runner out. That's Turner. Score it 5-2 on the throw home. And run it coming down is Yenzi. Moving over to second is Holderback. Wittmeyer with the fielder's choice safely on it first. So the bases are still loaded. Now you've got Zach Boyd up. And it seemed like that ball was hit sharply enough. There could have been an opportunity, but a little hesitation by the third baseman. First pitch strike delivered to Boyd.
I think the second baseman wasn't fast to the bag on that one. Might have been the problem for the third baseman holding up on that.
First pitch called strike to Boyd, number 21 in the Pioneer pinstripes. Runners all about, and one way upstairs that brings the catcher well out of the crouch. Drew Caroline up to grab that one. And that'll even the count at a ball and a strike to Zach Boyd.
Be a great time for Zach to get his first base hit of the season.
Runners lead at all the bags. Lefty's just twirling that ball behind his back. Now to the mitt. We'll take a look around behind him. Doesn't like what he sees. And then one cued off the end of the bat to bring the count to 1-2.
Yeah, Zach out in front of that changeup right there. Looked like he was sitting dead red. Got it just a little out in front of that one.
So back to work for Cassidy on Boyd. Pioneers would love to get a run here with the bases loaded. They do have one in the inning. And timeout at the plate.
And I know Coach Brewer would hate to leave the bases loaded. This would be a great time to find a nice sharp base hit down the line somewhere. Zach's pretty good at that.
Lefty to lefty, pitcher to batter. And a pitch on the way, swung on, and this one fouled off left side, right over the dugout of the captains of Christopher Newport, as all the players on both sides of this out hanging over that dugout, that true dugout that has them up to about their knees is field level, and then their arms out over the fence. It's taking in a little sunshine. Next pitch. This one fouled off the top of the helmet of the catcher. And so all of a sudden, we see Zach Boyd taking a couple pretty good cuts. He just hasn't found it yet. But those are smooth swinging cuts from number 21. I'll tell you that early on.
Zach Boyd has a beautiful swing, that's for sure.
Pitcher now again, we'll sight the side of Caroline. Check of the runner at second, and the pitch comes in and misses low. Two balls, two strikes, two out, and the Pioneers stacked on all the bags out there right now. Again, the sign. Yenzi dancing down the line at third. Pitch delivered is up and in. And that is going to fill the count. And so the string is out. You'll see the runner is on the move here as the pitcher goes into his move. And we'll see if ZB can get a bat on one right here with the runners moving. To the stretch. And the pitch on the way, and that's going to be down in the dirt. And the catcher is going to check to the field umpire, and that is going to be a ball four. The catcher jumped out and stepped on the plate, thinking he might have gone around. He was looking for the home or the field umpire to appeal, and they actually did check it, but it was ball four. So good at bat for Zach Boyd. Base on balls, give him an RBI. Bring Yenzi in what represents the second run of the inning and the ball game. Put Holder back down to third base. And your batter now is Alex Page.
Alex very capable of making a new ball game right here.
First pitch delivered is a strike, and I can bet he would love to see that one again. Page represents the eighth batter to the plate in the inning. Two runs have crossed, three base hits for the Pioneers in this inning.
Yeah, Cassidy hung a changeup right there. Looked like AP was taken all the way.
Holder back at third, Wittmeyer second base, Boyd at first. And the 0-1 to Page, swing and a miss.
Back-to-back changeups.
Got him inside, late swinging, 0-2. Alex Page in the DH spot today, sixth spot in the order. And Brett Carson is on deck, and if we see Carson up in this inning, that means good things are happening for the Atta Express. Here's the 0-2. It's a pitch away, and it's ball one. Marietta College Baseball on AM 1490, FM 101.3, WMOA Marietta. Online at WMOA1490.com. And on the WMOA 1490 app, wherever you are, whenever you are there. One ball, two strikes, two out. Page the batter. Base is juiced. Cassidy's pitch. Inside, ball two. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Third inning baseball. And the Pioneers have worked themselves back into this. They were down 6-0 when the inning started. This is the bottom of the third. Have picked up a couple of runs and would love to pick up a couple more. Here's a 2-2 pitch. Ball swung on, hit left side. Third baseman is up with it. He'll chase to the bag and beat Wittmeyer there, and that'll do it in the inning. So score, Page out, five unassisted, two runs, three hits, no captain errors, and the Bases left full for the Pioneers. Eight batters come to the plate. We roll out of the third and into the fourth with your score. Christopher Newport 6, Marietta 2. You're listening to the voice of the Atta Express. Schaefer, and you have been around this game for a little while.
Tell me, lifetime.
Give me a little bit of backstory on Jeff Schaefer.
Lifetime. Born and raised in Long Island. Went to University of Maryland. Played 3 years there. Drafted by the Baltimore Orioles. 14 years professionally. 5 in the big league level. Got out of the game. Did some other things for a very short period of time, and jumped in. Started an academy, and we're developing players. And now this is our this format here is coming from our nonprofit organization called You Deserve a Chance Foundation.
Fantastic. Jonathan Fisher is the batter. 2 balls, 2 strikes, a swinging strike, and then a ball away from Gino Sabatini after the first couple of pitches. So the 2-2 due here, and a ball swung on, hit back to Gino. He's going to gather it up and fire it over. What position did you play?
I was a middle infielder coming up, shortstop, primarily utility man in the big leagues. Big league time with Chicago White Sox, Seattle Mariners, and Oakland A's for 5 seasons.
Where was your low ball?
Low ball was everywhere. I started off in Bluefield, West Virginia, and then moved on from there to the Carolina League, which was Hagerstown, and to Charlotte, North Carolina, where I live now, and obviously right down the road from here. Rochester, then from there to the Angels organization.
First pitch delivered, a strike to the new batter. We're back to the top of the order, and Connor Clark, Jeff Schaefer, our guest. I ask you about low ball, and you were in the majors how long?
5 years.
5 years? Mm-hmm. I only ask you about low ball because I wonder, there's a ball hit up the middle, off the mound and into center field. That's a base hit, and the third in as many at-bats for this leadoff guy, Connor Clark, who woke up swinging today. That's 3 base hits for the leadoff guy, and he is a one-out base runner. But I wonder if the fields were like this.
Oh, not even close. Not even close. I mean, my first season was 81, and that was in Bluefield, West Virginia.
Beautiful
background, beautiful setting, but obviously the playing surface is nothing like we see these days.
Because this is
a stadium environment.
Yeah, this is crazy nice. Here's a throw over, runner back safely. So you make a difference? Is that the? You Deserve a Chance Foundation.
Yes,
so
correct.
Touch a little bit on that after this.
Sure.
This pitch. We've got a first pitch due home to the batter, Scott Crossan. Check of the runner by Gino, and a pitch delivered is a strike on the outside corner.
So the foundation, we started the foundation basically when we got involved. We noticed the cost of the game. I was so far removed from the amateur side, the youth travel side, that I had no idea how it had changed. Because when I came up, you play with your rec leagues and you play with your local teams. You didn't travel as much. You didn't go to Georgia or different things like that. You just played around town.
We'll pitch out there. We'll even the count 1-1.
And you know, we saw kids that came and tried out for us that couldn't afford to stay. Financial landscape is out of control as far as youth sports.
Oh, geez,
billion-dollar business and.
Jack of the runner, and a ball swung on. This one popped up and will be just a loud strike.
But it's, you know, it's unfortunate because, you know, this game offers so much more than just playing the game.
Sure.
You know, as far as experiences and opportunity and life lessons that, you know, and a lot of kids deserve the opportunity to move on to the next levels that just don't get it because they're boxed out financially. So we started You Deserve a Chance Foundation to kind of close the gap and provide opportunity for kids that were a little bit underserved.
Jeff, is it equipment? Is it a little bit of everything?
A little bit of everything. It's scholarship. It's equipment. We've done a lot of different things. We've moved equipment around the country. We moved equipment out of country for some organizations. Some in Colombia, South America. But predominantly, it's, you know, it's allowing kids to just, you know, be involved in an organization and develop. And
there's a ball swung on this one, foul left side. That's after a throw over the count 1-2.
And just, you know, give them the opportunity, one, to be in the game. But you know, we're not looking for kids to go to the big leagues. You know, we do have a couple players that have come through our organization and You Deserve a Chance Foundation that have been to the big leagues. But it's predominantly just upward mobility. Can these kids get a chance to go play in college? And if not, you know, at least they're in an environment with the life skills and the life lessons and opportunities, you know, create something that they may not get the opportunity to have.
1-2 due home to Crossan, but yet another throw over and head first back in there safely is Connor Clark. And so I've got a lot of folks tuned in right now and they want to learn more about this. Give me that site.
It's www.udacf.org. Udacf.org.
You deserve a chance. There's a throw down after a ball gets away and they're going to get the runner trying to take advantage. So a really good job by Logan Wittmeyer. We get to see his arm for the first time this year. And if they got a good look at that, I'm not so sure they'll take chances again. And the old go-to rule, at least for the Pioneers, and probably when you played, was if the ball's in the dirt, you better get going,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, you watch an angle out of the hand, and hopefully you're prepared. You're always anticipating in this game, so you're kind of anticipating something like that happening, so you're prepared. You don't want to, you know, you want to be prepared, not react.
Scored a 2-4, caught stealing. And that'll take the base runner out of the picture here. And a payoff pitch due home to the batter, Scott Crossan. And Sabatine will work himself out of this little bit of a jam. That one's fouled back into the net. Highlights of your major league career. What comes first to mind? I imagine you get that question a lot.
Well, I mean, obviously, there's so many different highlights along the way. But, you know, your first at-bat, your first home run.
Sure.
You know, first time you see a uniform in a clubhouse. But for me, it was my first major league start in Yankee Stadium.
Oh, sure.
And I grew up a Yankee fan.
There's a ball swung on. This one is lifted out into left field. And with the sunshine banging off the sunglasses of Zach Boyd, the final out is made. We're going to keep it here, Kyle, and again, an opportunity to talk to Jeff Schaefer. He is with the You Deserve a Chance Foundation and a former major leaguer. But so Rochester guy, right?
No, Long Island.
Oh, Long Island.
Eastern half of Long Island. Yep, eastern half of Long Island. And, you know, just fortunate enough to get an opportunity to go what I thought was south to Maryland, you know, coming out of there. And, you know, 3 years in the ACC, I had a good career there and just got the opportunity. It was a 11th round draft pick by the Baltimore Orioles at the time and got kind of stuck in that organization. I had a guy by the name of Cal Ripken ahead of me.
Yeah, and, that'll happen.
Yeah, that kind of happens.
A lot of guys got stuck behind him, right?
I did the right things, and fortunately the Orioles were very good to me, and they sold me to the Angels for $100, and things changed from there. I got over to the Angels and played Double-A that year and played for Joe Maddon. Obviously a storied manager in the big leagues and World Series champion. And just, it's just been, baseball has been an amazing journey for me outside of just playing. You know, the people that I've met, the opportunities to come to ballparks like this, travel around. I do some speaking from time to time. And we built a facility here in Charlotte. And it's called the Knot Hole Foundation. If you remember the old pictures where the kids looking through the knot holes. So the only difference between us and the picture is that we let them inside. They have to stay outside.
I love it. Yeah. I love it. Sounds like a logo.
Yeah, so it's a beautiful facility. The field looks like this. It was built by a guy that He built the AAA stadium downtown. He redid Wrigley Field, and he built, when they went from the King Dome to Safeco up there, and they went to Natural Surface, he built that as well. So our field looks like this. I mean, obviously the surrounding parts of it are not, you know, not stadium-like, not professional in terms of, you know, drawing fans, but we have a beautiful, beautiful setup. We have three fields there. Small field, what we call a transitional field, where we can retro the bases from 60-90 down. Keeping the smaller, more skilled guys involved in the game and keeping it fast when they go from the small field to the big field.
Rewarding, obviously, for you to be able to not just do something that keeps you in the game of baseball, but to make a difference for those that maybe otherwise wouldn't, right?
It's, you know, it is. I'm enjoying this part of being in the game as much as any other part of it, and it is extremely rewarding for not, you know, you say for me, but we have a staff. You know, Andrew Zeich that's here with us and Sue Zeich and a few other members on our board that just keep making a difference, and it is rewarding. It's, you know, the game has been extremely good to me. That's, you know, that's not the Chico Escuela thing that, you know, that's been Betty Betty good to me. It's been phenomenal to me, and everything basically in my life comes from the game. And, you know, to be able to give back and do things and make a difference in other players, you know, in youth players' lives, it's phenomenal. And not just players, their families.
Bottom of the fourth, baseball, Brett Carson, the batter for the Pioneers. And a couple of pitches in, two balls and a strike to the transfer from Muskingum, a senior batting in the seven hole. Carson, the center fielder, ground out to second, his lone at bat in this game. The Pioneers haven't been up much. They did make a little noise in the third inning. Put a couple runs across to make it a 6-2 game. And now the 2-1 and a swing and a miss will even the count at two balls and two strikes. So you roll into Yankee Stadium as a player for the Orioles, right?
No, for the player for the White Sox.
Oh, for the White Sox.
I got to the big leagues with the White Sox. Yeah, interesting story to it, and kind of fill you in after this pitch. But
got Cassidy on the hill with nobody on pitching from the stretch and a pitch away.
Jeff Torbo was my manager, and he came up with the Dodgers, and Walt Alston at the time was the manager, saved his start for the Shea Stadium, so all his family from New Jersey could be there. And he told me that story in spring training, and it was just, you know, I just thought, that's a great story. But he did the same thing for me. He held me out for about 10 days from a start, and
payoff pitch to Carson popped up, and he'll get another one. That's foul ball.
And he gave me my first start on a Sunday afternoon in Yankee Stadium. I had about 170 people from my little town in Patchogue out there, and it was, it was chilling. I had played in an all-star game, a collegiate summer all-star game in Yankee Stadium, but to walk out there as a big leaguer and, you know, see your face and everything up on a jumbotron in Yankee Stadium when you've sat in the stands for so many years to watch him.
Next payoff pitch swung on. This one lifted out of center field. Center fielder going back at his leisure. He better pick it up. It's going to get over his head. Bangs off the wall. Carson's already at second, thinking about third, and here he goes. And he would be in there standing. 1-2-3 bagger for Brett Carson. Welcome to Marietta, my friend, from Muskingum. And a big triple to make a little noise here as a leadoff batter in the inning. Took a lot of pitches, couple payoff pitches, worked his way into that full count and got the one he wanted. And I'll say that Connor Clark started a little slow on the ball and then realized it was over. So I don't know that he could have gotten to it anyway. It hit about midway up on the wall, or about 5 feet up on the wall on the fly, deepest part of the ballpark.
Yeah, there's a breeze that's blowing out. So that's
another newcomer to the squad stepping in is A.J. Lovin. This is a sophomore, 5'9", 180, and in his first game in a Pioneer uniform, Lovin batting in the eighth spot. Runners at third base after the triple. And a little piece of it up top. Lovin upset with himself that he went after the high fastball. One ball and one strike. You mentioned Ripken, but I think about guys that get into the bigs that ultimately end up seeing, there's this little excuse me swing for strike two, 1-2. guys that they idolized, you know, so maybe guys on their way out, legendary guys like that.
Well, I got the opportunity to face Nolan Ryan.
Oh, my gosh. So,
first time I ever saw Nolan Ryan, I was in third grade, and they pulled us out of class to watch the World Series with the Mets, and Ryan was pitching. So to get the opportunity to face him, you know, later in life, and, you know, just intimidating, just the being.
One ball, two strikes. Jeff Schaefer is our guest here, and that's funny. You could always say, the first time I saw Nolan Ryan, I was in third grade. Second time, I was in a batter's box.
One for four. Yep.
One ball, two strikes at the plate. Again, stretch pitching is Cassidy on the bump. He's got to look over his shoulder to see a base runner at third, and this one is fouled back. So after getting down to the count, A.J. Lava, and a good at-bat to hang in there. Ball in a couple strikes to number 47, the old Buckowitz number. And we'll step back into the right-hand side of the plate. Would love to get the runner in. Nobody out. This is bottom of the fourth. Pioneers down 6-2, opening game of the season for Marietta. Eighth game of the season for their opponent, Christopher Newport. And a ball swung on. This one hit out into right field. Is it deep enough? Feels like maybe. Nah, they're going to hold the runner. And so that'll be an out. A fly out to right field, not deep enough to bring Carson in from third base. Tell me again about the foundation how the listeners can maybe get involved.
So we started the foundation in 2013, small donation to help a player, and that first player that we helped is in the big leagues with St. Louis now. His name's L.J. Newsom, a kid out of Choptank, Maryland, and needed assistance, needed an opportunity, and drafted out of high school, and ends up, you know, climbing to the big leagues pretty quick with Seattle.
First pitch strike to Busby.
So we raise money. We do certain things. We have what we call a home plate gala, which is a black tie affair, and we honor people for Spirit of the Game awards. It's not a statistic type of award at all. Although we talk about the statistics. And
there's a ball hit back to the pitcher, and he will eyeball Carson at third, and then throw over for out number two. He was going to take it into the dugout until he realized that's only two outs, but. Score the out 1-3.
So yeah, we do that. We have a golf tournament. Obviously, this event here, we're hoping that people would go to our website and go to our donation tab and help. Everything and every dollar that comes into our organization goes out, and nobody gets paid to do it. It's all pure philanthropy. And there's a number of players and people out there that need help. We know we can't change the world, but we can do it. We can do our part.
Fantastic. Turner Hill, the batter, and a first pitch delivered a strike to Turner. Lefty to lefty, curveball to Turner in and hit. Let that work its way into in an 0-1 count. Carson, who led off with the triple, has seen a couple outs happen in front of him. And so it's up to Turner maybe to get this one in. He'll take a look at one that the catcher keeps in front of him nicely. One ball, one strike, two out. Jeff Schaefer, our guest, You Deserve a Chance Foundation. We have one of our sponsors on the radio is the Marietta Community Foundation. We do a lot of similar things with our local Bantam League. So anything you can to get those kids out enjoy what I think is a great game. And there's a pitch that misses.
Yeah, we'll do camps. We do quite a few different things. Blood drives. You know, we bring the van. We have a facility down the road here in Charlotte that we just built, that I said earlier, and we'll bring out the trucks there. We'll do the health and wellness stuff. And it's been impressive, and it's definitely, like you said earlier, quite rewarding.
2-1 popped up foul territory. Third baseman moving over, and it will get out of play. That's good for the good guys. Good guys are Marietta, if you haven't figured that out.
Yeah, I figured that out. Okay. I figured that one out. Yep.
Hey, can you do this over our internet for you? Can you be impartial? Yes, I can do it. No, I can't be impartial.
Not always.
So, that's good. Yeah, we get a chance. So, I feel blessed, too. I peaked athletically at about age 7, but I still get to be around the game doing this kind of thing. So it's a lot of fun, and I'm sure you feel the same way. To be at the ball field, and you may not get the same feelings when you showed up as a player, but here's a ball lifted out into center field, and this one, the center fielder's got timed up perfectly, and that'll do it in the inning. I want to thank Jeff Schaefer for stopping by and sitting in. I appreciate it very much. Wish you the best of luck with the foundation and life in general.
Thanks for having us up here. We appreciate it.
Good to see you. And Andrew, he did give you – oh, Andrew's not in here.
Yeah,
I was going to tell him you gave him some love.
Yeah, he gets too much love. I shouldn't even done that.
All right. Good to see you, man. Appreciate it.
Take care.
All right, we're going to take a break and back with more after this timeout from Kannapolis, North Carolina. Virginia.
Yeah, it was quite the experience, you know, moving from, you know, the Big East Conference to, you know, professional guys. Definitely was a transitional period for me, and you know, that was the time frame of the Mike Stantons, the Freddie Freemans, Jason Haywards, and that was the exact same time. So those guys were in this league, and you know, they could swing it.
One ball, no strikes, new batter at the plate. One out batter is Kyle Schofield. And the next pitch on the way is going to miss a little bit high. My broadcast, my normal broadcast partner who couldn't make it this weekend, and I miss him dearly right now being here, but he played for OU, but he'll always have that, man, you know, the first game I pitched was at Duke. Or I went to, you know, it, so are there those stories from that game? Like, what was that game that you remember?
I would say that game for me in college was my actual first game pitching. It was against Nebraska in the Metrodome in Minneapolis.
Here's a ball lifted out into right field. Good job by Turner, man, on a rip shot line drive catch to size that one up off the bat. Go ahead, sorry.
No, yeah, that was the first time, you know, going out and actually pitching in college, so it was quite the difference of playing in high school, you know, starting up with a team that was in the top 25, and, you know, I've always been a good college baseball program. So that was the college experience. Professional experience is, you know, it's a little bit different. You know, you don't really know sometimes who you're facing and until, you know, 10 years down the road, you see them in the big leagues and, you know, they're starting and, you know, becoming a franchise type player. The year that I was here, I actually tied Madison Bumgarner for wins in the league.
Oh, wow.
And it was one of those situations where you really didn't know who Madison Bumgarner was yet, but,
right,
you know, now you do. So,
one ball, one strike at the plate, and now it looked like a strike. Two balls and a strike. They'd have given you that one, Zach, for sure, a strike here, but not to Gino. Two balls and a strike. Two-out batter is Justin Bowers. And Gino looking to keep a clean slate through this middle innings. And there's another one that just misses. Popped the mitt. Three balls and a strike. Levi Maxwell now working with the advancement department at Marietta College.
Yes.
I want to hear about that transition as well, how you end up in our fair city. There's called strike three. Buddy, you can take that twice, but you're not going to take it a third time, right? That was on the corner. Called strike two. They took him off the board too. Payoff pitch due home.
Yeah, my wife is originally from close to Marietta in West Virginia, and you know we ended up moving back there once we decided where we wanted to kind of lay down some roots.
Ball hit right side, 4-3. That'll do it in the inning. And so, been good to you. I love to see young people coming back to the Etta, and hope you get my number and let me know if there's anything you need around town, because we'd love to keep you around. It's good to hear your story. I appreciate you jumping in here for talking to us a little bit. Wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
All right, man. Appreciate it. Good to see you. All right. That is Levi Maxwell. He's with the Advancement Department of Marietta College. He also played his ball here in Kannapolis when they were the Intimidators and went on to get some minor league stuff in as well. We thank him for jumping in as we are going to jump into another break here. This is the halfway point of this nine-inning game, and it has been nine in a row that Gino Sabatine has put down through 3, 4, and 5. We roll into the bottom of the fifth. When we come back, it is Christopher Newport, 6, Marietta 2. You're listening to the voice of the Atta Express. All right, had my headset off there for a second if you said anything, Kyle, but I'm back. All right, thank you. See, we've got Yenzi Holderback and Vipmeyer coming up here for the Atta Express as we roll into inning number 5. I've also got Josh Jacobs in the house with Marietta College as well. Talk a little bit about your trip coming down here. Just drive it down by yourself, or did you come down with other folks?
We took the flight out of Parkersburg morning. It was a great trip, a $40 trip from Parkersburg to Charlotte.
You gotta be kidding me. That's crazy, isn't it?
It was great. We have a couple of staff members down here. We're hosting some alumni and friends of the college. We're going to be entertaining them this evening and then cheering on the Pioneers for their games tomorrow as well.
That's fantastic. First pitch in the bottom of the fifth, inside ball one to Damian Yenzi, open stance, number 10 in the pinstripes. Next pitch called strike, and that'll even things up. So, Josh, for the folks that haven't met you, don't know you, give us a little background on when you rolled into Marietta College, and then you give us a little taste of what you're doing here with the advancement, some of the folks, but maybe a little background as well. There's a pitch that misses ball two.
Yeah, it's been a great introduction to Marietta and Southeast Ohio. My family and I moved in the beginning of 2020, and so, Johnny, as you know, the the experience was not normal.
Right.
Haven't had a chance to get to meet as many people, but you and I had a chance to run into each other at some Rotary events and some other local activities, and it's been an absolute joy to get to know the Marietta community and have my family engaged in the school system, starting to get to know some of the community outreach and community activities. We just love the First Friday events and, and all the activities that happen throughout the community.
Cassidy still on the hill for Christopher Newport. Three balls now, a third ball thrown. Here's the 3-1 to Yenzi. Rip shot, base hit into left field. Could be extra bases. Yenzi's rounding first. He is head to second. Throw will come in after him. It's a stand-up double for number 10, Damian Yenzi. And that's a good way to get things started for the Pioneers. So Josh Jacobs, we get to be neighbors in this town, so that's kind of cool. Tell me a little bit about the growing up history. So
Originally born just outside of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, so coming back to the Ohio River after moving away for a number of years was kind of like coming home a little bit. And so born outside of Pittsburgh, moved around and outside of Philadelphia, Southern Michigan, a little bit of time in Indiana.
Drew Holderback, the batter, first pitch strike to Holderback. So strike at the plate. Yenzi, leadoff hitter with the double. And a 6-2 game, but the Pioneers with a runner on and nobody out here in the bottom of the fifth. Check of the runner at second. Pitch on the way to Drew, down low. Gets away from the catcher, but not far enough. So tonight, what's the... You just an invite of folks to where?
What? Yep. So we've got a couple of folks we're going to host at the Top Golf here in Charlotte and talk to them about the college, learn a little bit about their experience with the institution, and try and make some connections. We're always looking for the opportunity to connect some students with alumni and friends, whether that be for career paths or whether that be for mentorships. So we're going to be exploring some of those relationships tonight and hoping to find ways to connect people's passion with the mission of the institution to advance the fine college that we love.
Fantastic. One ball, one strike pitch is framed nicely and called strike two by the catcher, Caroline. And so now Holderback jumps on the next one. This is out into right field. It will drop in. Picked up on one hop, but Holderback's going to try to stretch it into two. He does. Runner coming home. Throw on the way. Unfortunately, they are going to get Jens trying to sneak home. I don't know. And I didn't see if there was a hesitation between third and home. I can tell you right now, Coach Brian Brewer pacing the back end of the cage. You would not want to be in the same cage right now. But I don't know if Jens got caught up or not in between or hesitated at all, but the bottom line is the throw out at home. Good job by the right fielder to bring it in. It ends up being a 9-4-2. What'd you get in the middle? I didn't see if he threw it all the way home or not. Center fielder came up with the shot. Runner safe, Holderback pushed it in and was safely into second. And it was an 8-4-2 to get Yenzi at the plate. And safely as Holderback. And so Logan Wittmeyer, now the batter at the plate. First pitch to him is a strike. Credit the double for Drew, and a strike at the plate makes it 0-2 quickly to Wittmeyer. Back-to-back base hits, but an out at the plate. And old number 41 in the pinstripes down there scratching up a scorecard. Check of the runner. Wittmeyer at the plate. 0-2. Got to protect. Ball hit by the pitcher. Second baseman charges but boots it. And that is going to keep all hands safe. E4 will allow Wittmeyer safely on at first base. It will push Jens down to third. Check that. It will push Holder back down to third. And so runners on the corners for Zach Boyd. Boyd reached on a base on balls, and that allowed a run to come in. And so he was up with the bases loaded and walked the run in. And with that, no balls and a strike. So for somebody to roll into a new town and try to get acquainted with other folks in the year 2020, you've done a heck of a job, I'll tell you that, just because I got to meet you. I know a lot of folks. So however you did it, you could do a seminar on that as well. First pitch is a ball to the batter, Zach Boyd. One ball, no strikes, one out, two Pioneers on. And the ball waving out, or that bat over the bat, a throw over to first and the runner back safely. And so good turnout in terms of, did you have like RSVP or what? So how did that work out when you sent that out?
We definitely had a great response rate. We've got about 20 folks coming this evening to hang out with us and talk Marietta. And we've got about 130 folks RSVP'd for the events tomorrow.
Oh, wow.
So I think one of those ways in which you connect with people is the amazing sports that Marietta College provides. We were out last night cheering on the men's basketball team to a win in the OAC tournament and looking forward to Saturday's games. And then, you know, roll right into baseball season and cheer on this fantastic, absolutely fantastic Marietta baseball team. It's really hard to sit here on the radio with you, Johnny, and not cheer real loud into my microphone every time something happens. I'm trying to keep it locked up,
hey,
I promise.
I've had Hill over here, so I'm good, used to it. Two strikes at the plate now. One swinging strike, one looking strike for Zach Boyd. One ball, two strikes, one out, two runners on base. Bottom of the fifth inning baseball. Score remains 6-2, Christopher Newport leading, and just the lone out. Big pitch, Boyd, swing and a miss, strike three. Strike him out, they try to strike him out, throw him out, but the shortstop is going to come in, and or check that, the second baseman is going to chum and come in and cut the ball off so that they don't score the run. That's two down. Swinging strike three by Boyd. How about, who would have ever thought that you watch an OAC basketball game on a Thursday night, wake up, jump on a plane, you're in Charlotte in an hour, right?
Yeah, living the dream.
And then, and we have the great collision of really two really good teams. Swing and a miss to Alex Page, first pitch into the DH.
It's absolutely the way you want to live a week.
That's
go
right.
From game to game.
What are we going to do? What are we going to do to top this game? Well, we're going to jump on a plane and we're going to go watch baseball tomorrow. Got a righty up in the pen of the Marietta College Pioneers. Got AP at the plate. Runners at second and third. Need a hit. Pitch up high. That'll even the count at a ball and a strike. Josh Jacobs is our guest in the booth. And are you? Do you have a title? I know you're with the advancement department. But
yeah, vice president for advancement. So people often ask, what is that and what do you do? And I like to describe it as we connect people's passion with the mission of the institution. And when someone's passionate about something and we can connect them with what we do at Marietta College, they want to participate, they want to engage, and they want to support it. And so we try and find those ways that we can connect people with the wonderful transformational work that's occurring daily at Marietta College. And we've got a full team. You met Levi Maxwell, one of them, just a moment ago. We've got a number of people out on the road working to make those connections on a daily basis.
Ball two was low, and now a strike delivered a fastball. So two balls, two strikes, two outs, two on. And Griffin Malik is the guy that is down in the pen for the Pioneers. But right now we're trying to get to Mr. Cassidy, the lefty on the hill. This is the ace of the staff for Christopher Newport. Alex Page, and that's going to be strike three called. So Page goes down looking. And the Pioneers, for all it's worth, come out of that inning empty. Opportunities abound, runners on all the bases, and cannot get anything out of it. So we will move into the sixth inning of baseball. And it is still Christopher Newport 6 and Meredith College 2. Josh Jacobs, thank you, my friend, for jumping in here. We'll do it again sometime around the corner. Good luck tonight throughout the course of this weekend. You're doing a great job, I can tell. So I appreciate your time here.
Thanks. We're having a bunch of fun. Yeah. Go right. Pios.
You got a great radio voice as well. We'll be back with more from Kannapolis, North Carolina. Christopher Newport 6, Marietta 2. You're listening to the voice of the Atta Express. Looked pretty promising, comes all for naught. But we'll roll into the sixth and see what we can do with Griffin Malik. First pitch swinging, ball hit to right, chasing over Turner Hill. Great catch in right field. One down on a ball that was absolutely ripped in what appeared to be the gap. But the gap is a lot smaller out there when you got number 38 in right field. That'll bring Kevin Mackman to the plate. So credit Gino for settling down. He got really roughed up in the first couple of innings. Obviously, there's a sixth spot on the board for Christopher Newport. That's one in the first, five in the second, including facing 10 batters in the second. But then retired the sides a little bit around a roundabout way in the third inning. But third, fourth, fifth, facing the minimum number of batters was Sabatine. And now we're going to see Griffin Malik come out here and see if he can't keep the same going. One ball, one strike, one out. New batter at the plate, Kevin Mackman. And this is right-handed pitcher to left-handed batter, and this is a little 58-footer that Malik bounces in there. Number 72 in the pinstripe, 6'2", 161, Akron Ellett High School. And the right-hander will fire a pitch up and away, three balls and one strike. And after the cavalcade of stars and guests and major league players and minor league players and advancement people, Steve Hill jumps back in here to keep me breathing. So there's ball four. Really good at bat from McMahon. I mean, he didn't do anything but watch a lot of pitches, but a good job to know where they were going to land. And so that ends up being a four-pitch walk for Mac Mann, and He will get on first base with one out. Drew Caroline is the batter, the one-out batter into the right-hand side of the plate. Number 11 on his back in royal blue of the Christopher Newport Captains. And a first pitch delivered is ball one. We've got a little taste of an intimidator when they were called the Intimidators. That's so cool. And now the guy works at Marietta College, played his ball here at the minor league level. That was Levi Maxwell. There's a pitch called strike. One ball, one strike to this new batter, Drew Caroline. One on, one out.
Very neat story there, Johnny. It's kind of amazing. Marietta College seems to keep bringing in people like that.
Yeah. Yeah, Jacob's really good too, Josh.
Yeah.
There's a throw over. And back in there safely is the base runner. Three of umpires out there today. And the sign from Logan Wittmeyer to Griffin Malik. Pitch delivered, misses inside. Two games on the slate tomorrow for the Marietta College Pioneers. We'll get underway at 10 a.m., 9:45 go time if you want to hear from the coaches pregame. And Keystone and Washington and Lee are the teams on tap. A lot of baseball to play yet in this one, though. We're in the sixth inning. There's one popped up, foul territory. Vitt gives chase to as far as he can before that one bounces out and to the stands. See Bob Ferguson down there. I think he's hosting some folks tonight as well. So all kinds of people rolling in and taking players out to dinner and alums and high society stuff going on around here. Not sure if I'm invited to any of it or not. Two balls, two strikes, one out. I take that back. I'm actually invited to both. So 2-2 due home, but a throw over to first. Got Bantamleague baseball kicking off back home. Registration for the upcoming baseball and softball season, March 4th and 11th. They'll do it after work 5 to 7 at the concession building the next couple of Fridays. Here's a sharply hit ball. Holder back throws to Busby, and then Griffin Malik over to cover. They get the lead runner, but they don't get the double play. So let's take Mackman out of the picture, score it 3-6, and then with the fielder's choice safely on is Caroline, but two out. And that'll bring Jonathan Fisher to the plate. And the Pioneers looking to get out of this, get to the bottom of the sixth. Don't need them all, but just get a couple. One's back, maybe they should have. Next pitch on the way, swing and a miss. Little change up.
We've left a lot of guys in scoring position so far in this ball game.
Right-hander on the hill is Griffin Malik, second pitcher of record for Marietta College. The batter at the plate is Jonathan Fisher. He's the ninth batter in the lineup, so we'd just as soon save the top of the order for the seventh inning. There's a strike delivered. No balls, two strikes, two out, one on.
Griffin seems to be hitting the spots now. That was a beautiful pitch right there at the Hall of Knees.
Atrium Health Ballpark, Kannapolis, North Carolina, the site of this opening game for the 2022 Atta Express. But they're down 6-2 to Christopher Newport. Swing and a miss on one upstairs. And again, taking a little bit off of it is Malik. I think he knew when that one left his hand that it was the right pitch, and a swinging strike three will do it in the inning. No runs, no hits, no errors. One runner left aboard to the home half of the sixth inning. It's the Captain 6, the Pioneers 2. You're listening to the voice of the Atta Express. Down 6-2 in a game that's skipped right along. You usually don't say that a game that's moving right along, but I don't want it to move along any more quickly because I want to get a big offensive inning out of my boys here in game number one. First pitch strike delivered, and Griffin Malik on the hill for the Marietta College Pioneers. Batter at the plate.
Back to the top of the order with the center fielder, Connor Clark.
Yeah, Clark will hit one out. It just kind of falls in between all three, right field, center field, and second base, all out there, and it hit square in the middle of all of them. That's kind of the way that it's been, but that's another base hit. And that guy has been up to the plate four times, and he has had four base hits. So with that being said, into batter number two in the inning and in the batting order for the captains of Christopher Newport, Scott Crossan has had a couple of base hits as well and a couple runs scored, and he'll drop a bunt down, charging Yenzi, throwing on the move, will get the runner. Tried to bunt his way aboard. He does move a runner into second, but score the defensive play 5-3. Really good job there. Yenzi charging. It does move Clark into second. Jay Cassidy is the batter due up, and he will remain out there. Pioneers again back at it. A split doubleheader tomorrow with Keystone and Washington and Lee. And then a week back home. And then down into Port Charlotte, Florida, and the Snowbird Classic, which will start next Sunday, a week from this coming Sunday. One ball, no strikes. First pitch of ball to the batter, Cassidy. Got a runner at second base. For the team that leads 6-2, and that's Christopher Newport. Pitch home, misses away. Pittmeyer in the crouch. Defensively, Zach Boyd in left. Brett Carson in center field. Turner Hill in right. Damian Yenzi at third base. Matthew Busby at shortstop. A.J. Lovin at second. And Drew Holder back at first. Logan Vittmeyer behind the plate, although right now he's out on the mound and in discussion with Griffin Malik, his pitcher. They try to get on the same page and try to take down the guy that is in control of this game, and that is the pitcher for the other team, who is also batting in the three hole. He's got a couple runs batted in this game to help his cause. And his name's Jay Cassidy. Swing and a miss. Whatever the meeting was about, it was a good thought. Two balls and a strike. Malik will check the runner And another good pitch, swing and a miss, popping the mitt.
Griffin sticking with the fastball. Good looking pitch right there.
You know you're in a minor league ballpark where you see Dippin' Dots, right? It's what they do.
You're right. Dippin' Dots in a beer stand.
You got it. Check of the runner. Swing and a miss. So three really good pitches. Let's bottle that meeting at the mound.
Yep.
Three fastball strikes. And the second out is recorded with Cassidy going down swinging. And that'll bring the cleanup hitter to the plate, Kyle Schofield. Schofield a base hit in three trips to the plate. And the sun sneaks behind a cloud here at the 4 o'clock hour in North Carolina. You're listening to Marietta College Baseball on AM 1490, FM 101.3, WMOA Marietta. Thanks for tuning in wherever you may be. There's a ball down and ball one to start things off. Malik just Schofield. Top of the seventh, scheduled for nine. Christopher Newport, six, Marietta, two.
After three straight fastballs to strike out the three-hole hitter, he starts off with a changeup in the dirt. There's the fastball.
It's a ball hit right side. Holder back over. Griffin to cover. 3-1 to put out. And in the inning, no runs, one hit, no errors. One runner left aboard as we head to the seventh inning stretch. Brought to you by Dr. Jeffrey Dexter, team chiropractor for the Eddie Express. Dr. Dexter and the staff at Marietta Health and Wellness offer the perfect balance of chiropractic and wellness for our community and Marietta College with licensed massage therapist, certified athletic trainer, and a licensed physical therapist on staff, Marietta Health and Wellness. We've got your back. And the seventh inning stretch, Christopher Newport, six, Marietta, two. You're listening to the voice of the Eddie Express. Okay.
Who's in his spot?
Got a new pitcher on the bump for Christopher Newport, a guy that's been in the game, Daniel Elliott. So that would mean I think we have a new second baseman out there as well. So we'll keep an eye out or get a number on that cat. And right now we'll see Elliott step to the pitcher's mound. Sophomore. We'll fire a pitch inside. Guy's got some pretty good stuff. First pitch is going to miss inside, ball one. Turner Hill the batter, so the Pioneers are at the top of the order to see if Turner can't set the table here. There's a pitch on the inside corner called strike. One ball, one strike. And a ball swung on out in front of the plate, first base side. And wow, what a play. This pitcher falling to foul territory. Submarine arms it down the line. First baseman can't see it because it's behind Turner Hill's back. He reaches out there and stabs it at the last minute. They get the out, score it 1-3. Great play by the pitcher and on the back end, the first baseman.
Yeah, the pitcher just came in from second base. He played that like a middle infielder.
There's a strike at the plate to Yenzi, and Justin Lykos is out there, a freshman at second base. new second baseman. And here's a pitch down low that'll even the count to Jens. Next pitcher on the way, sharply hit ball to the third baseman who knocks it down, picks it up, and fires it over. Mackman to Schofield. And a 5-3 put out. So off the back of the rubber, we'll see Daniel Elliott. This is a guy that started at second base, and obviously he's got some pretty good pop. This is a team that is 7-plus games into the season. They come in with a record of 3-4. They went over to Demarest and had Piedmont, Birmingham Southern. You know, those are the teams that we've opened up with on occasion on the front end of a season. There's a first pitch strike delivered to Drew Holderback. And this right-hander will sight the sign and fire another fastball that just missed somewhere. And the 1-1 pitch is going to be down low. Now, back in the day, I remember it so well, but Coach Sholley would go stop the game. He'd go out and he'd say, that pitcher has baby blue webbing on a black glove, and it's going to mess with my hitters who are trying to see a ball out of a hand. Here's a ball that skips off the mound, goes under the glove of the shortstop, and that will be a base hit and allow Holderback on safely. And so it careens off the mound, slows it down a little bit, and then the shortstop coming in tries to maybe scoop it up, and I don't know that he wouldn't have had a play. That's why they call it a base hit, and that becomes the third base hit for Drew Holderback today. If we're going to try to look down here and find shining moments in a game we're losing 6-2, Holderback would be it. Right-hander on the hill will sight the sign. Pitch on the way. Swing and a miss a bit. Got out in front of one. Number 29 in the right-hand batter's box. A two-out batter with a runner on base. And a foul tipped back into the mitt for strike two.
Big cut by Logan right there in that one.
No balls, two strikes, two out, one on. It is bottom of the seventh inning. Christopher Newport 6, Marietta 2. And the 0-2 to Vitt. Ball swung on, this
there
one hit over the head of the second baseman.
Third.
And Holderback is headed to three bag, and he'll be in there safely. Now the ball's in the middle of the field, and it will allow Vittmeyer to make a move over to second.
That's great heads-up base running, Johnny, by Logan.
It's what we see. Yeah, it's what you see the Pioneers do all the time. We call it at the ready. I think Coach Brewer calls it that as well. But you've got to be at the ready. And at the ready is when a ball gets into a spot where it typically wouldn't, meaning a defensive play on the throw-in. The second baseman just let it skip by him, and it ends up in the middle of the field. And the pitcher's down here at home plate backing up the catcher just in case your lead runner, Holderback, comes around, and so it's out in no man's land. Vittmeyer recognizes it and moves over.
What a great piece of hitting by Logan. Two strikes, stayed right down through the baseball. Just a nice little line drive out the right center field.
So Daniel Elliott now with a couple runners behind him and a first pitch look from the batter, Zach Boyd, and I think he would love to see that pitch exactly again the way it just came in, but it's called strike. No balls and a strike. Pitcher peering over his mitt. We'll sight the sign from Caroline. Elliott, Caroline, the battery. And the pitch home. Same spot, same result. Called strike two. Runners at second and third. Bottom of the seventh. Would love to get a couple here.
Zach, very capable of making this a ball game right here. Very capable.
And a pitch on the way, swung on, it is popped up into shallow left field. Left fielder coming in hard, though, and will just reach in and make the catch. He had to come a long way but he does get the catch, and so the Pioneers leave a couple out there in scoring position yet again. In the inning, no runs, two hits, no errors. Runners left at second and third. We're through seven, scheduled for nine. Christopher Newport, six. Marietta, two. You're listening to the voice of the Etta Express. Well, got to work our way through the captains at Christopher Newport, batters 5, 6, and 7. And a first pitch swinging foul ball for Bowers. Malik, Griffin Malik on the hill. And certainly appreciate the fans who are tuning in. So many different ways to catch the ball game anymore, but online or on a website or on an internet feed or the stream or the app or over the air. But particularly also want to thank those Christopher Newport fans who have tuned in and they get the Marietta College broadcast. So appreciate you bearing with the way I lean, because it's the only way I lean. Hey, root for the Pioneers.
Griffin's starting off with two fastball strikes and then throws a ball there. We got a one ball, two strikes.
Bowers, Elliott, there's a ball swung on, and this one lifted out into deep right center field, and that is going to get all the way to the warning track off the wall, and he's going to try to get to third and probably do so pretty easily. Head first sliding in there before the throw gets into the mitt of Yenzi. That's a triple for Justin Bowers. Pat, the stats, my man. That is a leadoff triple. And the only thing Pioneers can hope for is to do to the captains what the captains did to the Pioneers when Brett Carson had a leadoff triple for Marietta. Left him there. Left him there to watch three outs. This is top of the eighth baseball. And the captains looking to tack a couple more. Remember, they've had six runs since the second inning.
Coach Brewer elected to bring the infield in.
There's a ball swung on. This one out into left field. Going over is Zach Boyd. Will make the catch. Comes up firing. Throw on the way. Not in time. And the runner will tag and score. Ends up being a sack fly to left. Scores run number 7. And it's 7-2. That's pretty quick work. That'll bring Kevin Mackman to the plate. So, yeah, folks, we talked to Josh Jacobs, who jumped on that, I think it's a 9 a.m. flight into Charlotte out of Mid-Ohio Valley Airport, Wood County Airport. And gets in at 10:30 or so into Charlotte, and then not that far away to get to here as a ball lifted into shallow right field. And Turner Hill will come over to make the catch for out number 2. And big $40 spot on that. You can't drive here that cheap, I'll tell you that.
Oh, absolutely not. $3.58 a gallon. We just paid when we got down here in Charlotte area.
two-out batter will be Drew Caroline. And first pitch delivered, called strike.
Griff thrown primarily fastballs today, and he's got a little bit of pop to it.
No balls and a strike. Next pitch, called strike as well.
And there he is with the changeup, kind of up and away, and kind of froze the hitter, looked like.
Yeah, I'll show that Steve Hill. I'll throw a little something different in there just to get the same result.
Yes.
Here's the 0-2.
Back to the fastball away.
One ball, two strikes. So many different places to sit. If you're familiar with World Series in Appleton, it has a similar feel in terms of places to watch the game from. There's one foul tip back into the mitt. Good job by Vitt to hold on to that one, and that'll do it in the inning. But a run does score on an opening triple and a sac fly here in the eighth. That'll do it, though, for the Captains as the Pioneers come to the plate, bottom of the eighth, down to six outs, and this one is the home team. Christopher Newport, 7, Marietta 2. You're listening to the voice of the Eddie Express.
I want to thank Marietta's American Legion Post 64 for being a part of our broadcast. We thank American Legion Post 64 for all their efforts, the efforts of our veterans who have and continue to afford our freedoms here in America, including the guy to my left, Steve Hill. Right-hander on the hill, Daniel Elliott and Alex Page to lead things off. Pioneers again down to six outs, bottom of the eighth. They are the home team in that first base dugout. First pitch misses a ball to AP, and the next one's on the money, 1-1. Strike zone's got a little bigger as we get a little bit later in the day. Got another baseball team in the house, or a couple baseball teams. There's one hit up the middle. That is an opening base hit, and that's what the doctor ordered right there. We need a lot of those.
That's just a beautiful piece of hitting by AP. Stayed right down through it, put it right back where it came from. The umpiring crew has actually done a really nice job so far today, Johnny.
Yeah.
Very consistent.
Keystone and Washington and Lee will play in the game following this.
That brings Brett Carson to the plate. Carson, obviously, with that triple earlier in the game, about 5 feet up off the wall, dead center field.
With throw over, has the base runner Alex Page back hit first safely. To the belt for the pitcher, and a pitch that misses down low. Elliott took down the first two batters he faced in the seventh and then gave up a couple of hits before retiring the side, and now gives up the first hit here of this eighth inning, and then fires a ball and a strike, much like he did to Alex Page before AP had the base hit. So Carson steps in, left-handed batter. Pitcher on the hill is a righty. more of a bulldog, if you will, compared to the starter. Next pitch on the way, called strike two. Tight crouch, stretch. 7-2 now the score. Christopher Newport added another to the tote at the top of the inning. And a throw over. And Page in there, head first, back safely.
On the hit side of things, Johnny, I mean, Christopher Newport with 11 hits. Marietta's got 10. We've left a lot of runners in scoring position today.
Again to the belt for Elliott. Pitch delivered away. So two balls, two strikes. One on, nobody out. Eighth inning baseball, Pioneers down 7-2. There's a pitch away, ball three. Second baseman A.J. Lovin on deck for Marietta. Pioneers in the pinstripes today. Christopher Newport, royal blue jerseys and gray pants. There's another throw over. And CNU across the chest of that royal blue jersey in gray, trimmed in white. Jack of the runner, payoff pitch. Outside corner, called strike three. And down goes Brett Carson looking for out number one. That'll bring A.J. Lovin to the plate as a one-out batter. Right-hander on the hill. That'll give him a little extra juice. Pretty good lead for Page after having a couple thrown over there. There's a strike delivered to Lovin. Again, doubleheader baseball tomorrow, which will roll into OAC Tournament Championship basketball. There's a pitch home, called strike two. No balls, two strikes, one out. Congratulations, Coach John Vanderwall and company.
Yeah, I saw Jason Elliott, also player of the OAC Player of the Year. Or Jason Ellis, excuse me.
Jack of the runner, and a swing, and a miss. And that is strike three, so. One goes down looking, one goes down swinging.
Yeah, Coach Vanderwall, Coach of the Year, Jason Ellis, Player of the Year in the conference.
Fantastic. Well-deserved.
Well-deserved, absolutely. Looks like we got a pinch hitter here, hitting for Busby.
Yeah, that is going to be Alex Richter. Richter, a freshman out of Carmel, Indiana, 6'1", 185, lefty, bats left, throws right.
His parents made the trip down.
So number 18 will look at a first pitch strike. And again, Page leads at first base. Next pitch inside corner, beauty. Both had pretty good heat. No balls and two strikes on the debut at bat for Mr. Richter. And the next pitch, yeah, that's three pitch strikeout, and they were all fastballs. One away, one inside, one right down the middle. Back-to-back-to-back strikeouts to end the eighth for the Pioneers. Into ninth inning baseball we go. Christopher Newport 7, Marietta 2. You're listening to the voice of the Atta Express. Mark have just really kind of taken this game on. You know, right out of the gate, you had this guy get a base hit. He's got a couple RBIs, 4-for-4 at the plate. The lone blemish, he got caught stealing. There's one fouled off left side. He got caught trying to be aggressive after going 4-for-4 and scoring a run and having two runs batted in.
Yeah, he's had a good day.
The ball's in, a strike after the foul, and the next one misses away as the shadows from the press box of which we reside sneak out into the field of play. And the 1-1, and that one is fouled back and actually gets over the net and crashes into the window.
He does not get cheated early in the count. He has nice swings up there. Great approach at the plate.
Malik asks Vitt to go through those signs again. And the next pitch is going to bounce in. 2 balls, 2 strikes.
I mean, Griffin's come on today and done a really nice job today, Johnny. Throwing, like I said, primary fastballs, but he's done a really good job hitting the spots in the zone.
I mean, the sixth inning came in?
Yeah. Fifth or sixth, was it?
Yeah, sixth. And the pitch on the way, swung on hit left side. Up with it, A.J. Lovin, the new shortstop. Shows his wares, makes the throw across. Gets the put out 6-3 on what needs to be a really bang-bang play to get that guy out for the first time today.
Finally.
And that'll bring Scott Cross into the plate as the two-out batter. Crossin steps in. It's a base hit. A couple runs scored. First pitch swinging, a ball lifted down the line and into foul territory, out of play. And we'll draw our line of sight out to see some folks who have found that little spot in the grass on a hillside and outside the left field fence. And Malik, pitch on the way, hit up over the head of a jumping Richter at second base into the glove of Turner. And that'll be a base hit, 2-out style base hit for Scott Crossin. But a base runner nonetheless. And that'll bring a new batter to the plate in the form of Justin Lykos. He came in at second base defensively when the pitcher moved from second into the mound. That was Elliott. And so this is the first at bat for Lykos. And a pitch swung on, and he jumps at the first one out to second. A.J. Lovin flips it up, fires it over, and they do not get the batter or the base runner. So that'll be an error scored on Lovin, who I don't want to say didn't, well, I could say didn't field it cleanly, just but he gloved it and flipped it up in the air. So just that one beat. You know, just that one beat of having that ball not cleanly fielded. And now that'll charge him an error for that. E6, the official score. And with that, runners at first and second. Tough crowd here. I don't know if Jeff would have done that or not, Jeff Shalley. Speed down the line. Schofield, the batter now. And the next pitch delivered is a strike. Vitt knew it. 1 ball. 1 strike, 2 out, 2 on. Christopher Newport in control. 9th inning baseball. They lead 7-2. Pitch on the way. And that one misses a little bit low. 2 balls and a strike. Vittmeyer will hang the signs for Griffin, who will check the runner at second. Pitch delivered, called strike. And I don't think.
Crowd didn't like that one, did they?
Yeah, I don't think Schofield did either, but
yeah. Pioneer fans are okay with it.
You got to know when you're in the ninth inning and you're up by five runs, this umpire's knows that got a dinner date.
Two balls, two strikes. Pitch on the way, swing and a miss. Strike three.
Nice change up
there.
Yeah,
just pull the string on him a little bit, and that'll do it in the inning. No runs, one hit, one error. Couple runners left on base. We head to the bottom of the ninth. A little work to do. Christopher Newport, 7. Marietta, 2. You're listening to the voice of the Atta Express. Thank you, 90. Big five-run second inning. Christopher Newport has not looked back from that. Very quiet between the second and the eighth where they added another run. Thanks in part to Sabatine and Griffin Malik working. But Pioneers have not been able to capitalize on what represents 10 runners left on base. And down 7-2. And down to a couple outs. There's a couple.
I'm sure those 10 runners left on base is something Coach Brewer is going to address with his ball club.
Two balls and a strike. Right-hander on the hill. Try to close this out for the captains. There's one that misses low. Two balls and a strike. Check that, three balls and a strike. And the next pitch on the way, called strike two. That'll fill it up. Again, thank American Legion Post 64. Honest Fred's Flooring for bringing us the game day lineups today. Apex True Value, Pioneer Family Auto Group. There's a check swing. called strike three. Out number two recorded. We've seen a lot of those two backwards Ks in the book. Probably five strikeouts looking here in this opening game. Pioneers will be back at it again tomorrow at 10 in the morning, 9:45 our airtime. Drew Holderback steps in right now, and Keystone on tap. Pitch on the way, called strike. Christopher Newport, part of that kind of broken conference, and so they're trying to work their way into a really tough schedule. There's called strike two, two quick ones, and Daniel Elliott will walk off the back of the mound and just think about taking care of business right now. And pitch on the way, misses down a little bit low. One ball, two strikes. Batter in the shade of the press box, pitcher in the sunshine of a beautiful day. And the 1-2 popped up, foul, out of play.
Holdy's always a tough out. Still battling here. Down five runs with two outs in the bottom of the ninth.
We'll thank Kettle One Teamwear for, again, being part of our broadcast as well. Kettle One Teamwear, 313 Green Street in Marietta for the best in screen printing and embroidery. Kettle One Teamwear, strike three. And Christopher Newport kind of does in the ninth inning what they did the whole game, quite frankly, and that's just take us out of it. So three up, three down. And I'll go back and kind of round out. That happened at least three times, I think, in this ball game. But Christopher Newport will win this game in what we would call going away. Really, the Pioneers never threatened. I think they threatened to the point where having runners in scoring position with nobody out, but never got those runs across. And so they'll try to get back on the horse tomorrow. We're going to take a break. We'll be back to line this one out from Kannapolis, North Carolina. You're listening to the voice of the Etta Express.